This very unusual and actually probably almost unique memorial is to a pigeon given by the pigeon fanciers of France. And it's to commemorate a pigeon which was used by the commandant of the fort, Major Reynal, to send a desperate message on the 4th of June, begging for help because the fort had been cut off. Inside, they were living in the most horrendous conditions. The Germans had actually got on top of the fort and had found a way in, and they're actually fighting in the corridors. There are about 600 men inside. They shouldn't have been that many, but they've been taking shelter. A lot of them are wounded, and there are descriptions that the only water in the fort was sterilized with just 3 liters of chlorine per liter. There was none on the 1st of June, 1 liter per man on the 2nd, and none on the 4th. There were nearly 100 wounded in the hospital, and some were so desperate for water that they were drinking, licking the walls, and drinking their own urine. It must have been foul inside. And Reynal sent the pigeon with a message, "We're still holding. Relief is imperative. Communicate with Morse Blinker from Souville, which does not reply to our calls. This is my last pigeon." And that was the last message indeed that was able to be transmitted. 3 days later, on the 7th, Reynal has to surrender. The pigeon itself was wounded on its way back to its dovecot in Verdun. It died and it was actually stuffed and preserved, but given the Legion d'honneur for its work. And Reynal surrendered, as I said, on the 7th. The Germans gave him an honourable surrender. They actually gave military honours to the French that had surrendered because they'd fought so fiercely. And the Crown Prince actually returned Reynal's sword to him. But this is a memorial to that action. And of course, the final tragedy that took place here was that they didn't know what had happened. And on the 8th, the French launched a counterattack to try and to get through to the fort. And they actually reached the environs of the fort when German machine guns opened up on them, because they did not know that the Germans occupied the fort. So again, that was another tragedy. So Vaux is a very, very evocative story, and quite a unique place, in fact, on the battlefield of Verdun.